We're here for the World Junior Championship press conference with the team representative of the top three winner. We're going to start first in the middle with Eric Verdas, donc representative of VDK Racing Team, who's going to be speaking in his own language, French, for this press conference. Then Marco Paulin and Glenn Cavart for CRG and Paulin Racing Team. Eric, on peut commencer avec vous, un week-end fantastique pour VDK, le titre mondial pour Victor Bagnier, le deuxième français à remporter un titre de cette envergure. Racontez-nous un petit peu votre sentiment à l'heure actuelle.
Ben, sentiment ben, de joie, ça c'est la première chose. Après, ben, je vais dire, je voudrais d'abord toujours remercier tous les gens qui travaillent pour nous. Je vais dire, on a une équipe fantastique autour de nous. C'est un an de travail, c'est beaucoup, beaucoup de sacrifices pour tout le monde. Je ne vais pas citer tout le monde, mais voilà, ils ont fait un travail fantastique, tout le monde, que ce soit les mécaniciens, d'autres pilotes, tout le monde travaille pour tout le monde. Et voilà, ça met une joie immense dans le team. Et oui, c'est un sentiment énorme et c'est un sentiment qu'on partage tous dans le team. Et voilà.
Du point de vue du team, est-ce que vous pouvez nous raconter un petit peu comment s'est passée la journée de samedi et aussi déjà un peu vendredi, parce qu'on a vraiment traversé des conditions météorologiques très difficiles ici en Suède. Du point de vue du team, comment est-ce que vous êtes parvenu à gérer cette stratégie?
En fait, c'était vraiment, enfin, c'était bien ça, vendredi. Là, je pense qu'on avait un bon setup. Après, samedi, quand on est arrivé la première manche sur la pluie, on n'avait pas fait un mètre ici à Kristianstad sur l'eau. Bah, face quand même, je veux dire, aux Nordiques ou aux gens qui ont déjà roulé ici sur la... C'était un peu compliqué. Victor, lui, a bien limité les dégâts. Après, j'ai d'autres pilotes qui ont eu plus difficile parce que, je veux dire, en rencontrant ces conditions-là, ben, c'était pas simple. Après, on a limité les dégâts le samedi pour essayer, en sachant que de toute façon, il faisait sec aujourd'hui. Et voilà, on espérait le sec. On a eu le sec, donc tout s'est bien terminé.
Merci beaucoup. Félicitations. Congratulations. Merci. Over to Marco Paulin, representative of the Paulin Racing Team for Gabriele Meini. Marco, an hectic weekend, a bit up and down in the heats and in the race, but at the end, another fantastic result for your driver, Gabriele Meini.
Yeah, I can't hide. It's a sort of bittersweet sensation for us, since we had a good pace to win. But unfortunately, our Saturday compromised a bit the starting position. And I think Victor was able to find his way through the lead and manage it. And Gabriele did a perfect race, and he could the maximum he could do starting from there was second place. If we see the broad picture, I'm very happy of the season. I'm very happy of what all the mechanics and the whole team did in these last months to prepare this race at maximum level. And I'm very happy of the season of Gabriele, who is vice world champion, vice European champion. He won the WSK, and I couldn't expect more from a rookie driver. So overall, we are happy of the season.
Thank you very much, Marco Paulin. Grazie molto. Moving over to Glenn Cayart, representative of the CRG team. Let's recap on the weekend. Glenn, it has been a beautiful result for your driver, Gabriele Bortoleto. Talk us through a bit of the result through the weekend, especially on Saturday and Sunday in the final. Third position at the end.
Well, first of all, I would like to congratulate Eric on his title, because we have a long story together, so it's good to be sitting here next to him. Makes me also proud about what we did together in the past. For Gabriele's race, he's been quite steady all week on dry conditions, wet conditions. He's been driving very well all week, always maximizing the pace he had on track, and getting a good starting position for the final. Obviously, starting on the outside in the final was difficult, and we already saw in the final that he had some problems in the start, so he lost a lot of position in the first lap, which compromised for sure his final, and he managed to get through the pack with good speed. But I think in the end, he used too much of the package, of the tires, of the engine to make sure he could finish the race to get Berrier. So in the end, we are a bit disappointed, because obviously we came here for the title. We end up with a third spot, but still we are proud of what Gabriele did. I'm proud also about the team, the work they did this week in these difficult conditions, because it was really tough 15 drivers to have here, and then all the changing conditions, it was very tough for everybody. So I'm proud to have a good team, to that we work good together to make good choices all week, and this is a good time to say thank you to everybody.
Thank you very much for talking to us today. Thank you very much to the three of you, Eric Verdasdonk, Marco Paulin and Glenn Kerwaert.